Hey, what's going on, guys? So this video is following the first one, part two, class trial, where we have to agree now. This game is gonna literally kill me. Make your argument. Tedru's account, Chiki's account. Okay, Nekomaru's account is that someone was in the bathroom. Someone's been in the bathroom ever since the beginning. What's her name's account? Tedder's.
She could have caught.
That's impossible.
It's impossible.
Huh? Why is it impossible?
Because I was not in the office.
Okay.
Not even before the blackout.
She was not in the office, not even before the blackout.
What happened to your guard duty?
Sorry.
Oh, you weren't in the office?
No.
That's clearly a desperate excuse.
Just listening to Pekka is not weird to doubt her, but I felt like I spoke to someone during the investigation who totally backs up the testimony.
Since Pekka was in the office.
Not even before the blackout.
I agree with that.
Break. Yes, I love breaks.
No, I think Pekka was telling the truth.
I agree.
Don't tell me you're crushing on Pekka.
It's nothing like that at all. Nekomaru's account is actually Pekko's alibi.
I've been trying to use it many times, and the doors won't open.
It's true. Someone was occupying the bathroom for a long time shortly after the party started. And it was finally freed up after Byakuya's body was discovered.
Yeah.
Then the person who was in the bathroom that whole time was actually...
Everyone else besides Pekka was in the dining hall after the party started. Right?
Yeah.
I see. So there's no way anybody else could have locked themselves in the bathroom except Pekka.
I guess that would be... true.
You locked yourself in the commode? You should have said so earlier!
There's no way she'd actually say that. Gosh, you are so insensitive.
She locked herself in the bathroom for that long? There's no doubt. It's shit. Oh, there's no way she'd admit it. There's no way she'd admit she was taking a shit.
Hey, weren't you guys taught any basic manners? Or were you raised in a locker room?
Yeah, guys.
I'm sorry.
It's fine. How about we stop talking about this and move on to something?
You know who's not talking right now? Nagato.
Don't worry. The smell wasn't that strong. I used the bathroom right after you, so you can trust me.
I said it's fine.
But still, you were in the bathroom for a really long time. Did you get food poisoning or something?
As soon as I stepped into the office, I felt this sudden rush of pain in my stomach. Because of that, I was unable to leave the bathroom, including when the blackout occurred.
Hey, how did it feel to do your business in the dark? Did you get excited? Seriously, stop it.
But still, your stomach pain. Was that really just a coincidence?
Hey, what's the deal? Don't butt into other people's business, especially if you didn't do any investigating.
You see what he has to say?
I'm only butting in because you fucking idiots are out of your element.
Stop this childish nonsense. Just what do you mean by coincidence?
What I mean is it possible someone slipped her some laxatives?
Oh, shit.
Laxatives?
If so, the killer could have tripped the breaker as soon as that girl left the office, don't you think?
Dude, Fuhiko, you're awesome.
I see. That might have happened.
Fuhiko, you're so good. Oh, that's so smart. Depending on the answer, change drastically. Jesus Lord, okay. Make your argument. Here we go. Knife, AC timer, night vision goggles, embarrassing pose. I'm gonna go with embarrassing pose.
Did you eat anything weird?
I don't remember eating anything weird.
Now that you mention it... You brought food to the office, right?
Yes.
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
Turo cooked the food, how suspicious!
Gosh darn it.
I wouldn't do anything like that! Laxatives would ruin the taste! Crap!
Shit. Okay.
There might have been some laxatives in it, don't you think?
No, that's wrong! No! It's impossible that laxatives were slipped into the food in the dining hall, because Pekka wasn't the only one who ate that food. Akane ate some of it too.
Agreed.
If the food had laxatives in it, I'm pretty sure Akane would have had stomach issues as well.
I feel totally fine!
Like I said, the dishes are innocent. Don't go making weird accusations.
I apologize for causing a scene.
Fuyuhiko should apologize, not you. He's the one who made the laxative accusation.
What the fuck did you say, bitch?
Cease this bickering.
Let's just dismiss Peko's stomach ache as a coincidence and go back to discussing the blackout.
Thank
yeah,
you, girl.
Yeah. We already know that, you trashy skank. You don't have to tell us.
Girl.
Trashy skank?
As long as the murder happened during the blackout, then the blackout itself is what's actually important. So we need to make it clear how the blackout occurred. I'm gonna go with the AC. I'm gonna go with the irons in the storage room.
Who tripped the breaker and how did they do it? If you can't answer that, I'm gonna bop you on the head. Did they throw a stone and hit it?
Maybe they used a remote control?
They probably messed with the breaker.
Crap!
Crap! Oh, the heart. No one messed with the breaker.
It does not have to be the breaker.
It doesn't have to be the breaker.
They may have tampered with the power supply and transmitters.
They must have tampered with the power supply and the transmitters.
Or maybe they caused a power surge?
I agree with
Thank God I hit that, dude. The aiming reticle is, like, constantly moving. Whoo! I'm glad I didn't put this on hard. Good thing this is a tutorial thing. I'd just be god-awful at this. Instead, of course, it's not a coincidence. Someone caused the intention.
Which is why those three irons were arranged to cause the blackout.
When you found them right after the blackout, the irons were still on, right?
So by leaving those irons on in the storage room, they Everybody's deliberately caused a power surge.
The only one who's not contributing is what's-his-name, because he's stupid.
Yeah, it seems that's how the killer caused the blackout.
Stupid fool!
Oh, let's go. Me and you, dude.
Hold on a second, let me speak too!
What the heck?
You say the irons in the storage room were used to trigger the blackout? That's inexcusable!
Why? Explain to me why. Fuck me, dude. AC timer. I'm going with the AC timer.
If the irons in the storage room caused the blackout, then for the killer to turn the irons on, you're saying they went all the way to the storage room? And that means everyone when the blackout occurred can't be a suspect.
No, just because people were in the dining hall doesn't mean they're not a suspect.
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to cause the blackout. If the irons caused the blackout, then the killer had to go to the storage room before that.
Retreat.
Damn it!
What else could it be?
But the people in the dining hall weren't able to. If the irons caused the blackout.
Allow me to cut through those
words. I just wasn't hitting it. I knew it was the AC timer.
The irons are just one reason the blackout occurred. But they weren't the direct trigger. Was when the air conditioners in the dining hall and office clicked on.
The air conditioner!
The timers for both air conditioners were set to
11:30 p.m. Mr. Ham Ham's died around that time too!
I see.
When the timers activated the air conditioners,
yeah,
the breaker was tripped and caused a blackout. I see! I understand!
This class trial is more about, like...
Indubitably?
Fastness.
They probably checked the old building's energy usage in advance, and used the irons to nearly max it out. So once they set the air conditioner's timers, they just had to wait until they started up on their own.
If so, even if Pekka was in the office, it still would have been possible to cause a blackout, indubitably.
Indubitably? Miss Sonia, not you too.
Regarding the energy usage, they probably asked Monokuma about it.
Dun dun dun!
Huh.
Is she right? Such a hateful bear! You deserve to die 1,000 deaths!
A thousand, you say? If I died that many times, I might really stay dead, you know?
Shut up! You guys just stay quiet!
I couldn't have prevented the blackout even if I was in the office. Even so, I feel regret. If I was in the office, I could have reset the breaker in time. And maybe the murder wouldn't have occurred.
No. The breaker in the office was built into a high area.
Yeah, but she has a sword.
That's impossible to reach. Resetting the breaker in that darkness would have been impossible, no matter what.
Sounds like you don't need to blame yourself.
Even so, the killer is so sly. I'm starting to worry we may never actually find them.
It's all right. You don't have to worry.
Hey, Nagato. I freaking suspect the F out of you.
Because they're just a petty killer, right? They can't defeat symbols of hope like you guys.
Is this
right?
There's
no way everybody will lose now. This little incident will just be a stepping stone for you all.
I knew it.
In the end, hope always wins. That's what I believe.
I knew it.
Huh? What do you mean?
Well, you have been saying this whole time that there's no way a killer could be among us.
Oh, is that so? Well, let's just put that minor detail aside for now and talk about the incident.
I like how the music change completely gives away that he's the one who did it.
For now, we found out how the blackout occurred. But the question is, who caused it? Anybody could have hid and set the timers for the air conditioners.
You were there beforehand.
Setting up the irons in the storage room could have been done before Byakuya set foot in the old building.
Why are you suspecting yourself?
What a shame. Any one of us is capable of that.
No.
What are you implying?
He's just saying, after all this time, we still haven't made any progress.
Huh? Even though we have been arguing for so long?
Fortunately, it's the truth. Despite the fact that we've discussed this at length, there's not even one clue that...
But there is. You were there beforehand.
That might be because there's no way any of us could be a killer.
It's you, dude.
You're changing your story again?
Anyway, I have an idea about what we all should do at this point. Has anyone thought about our situation like this? Instead of surviving by doubting others, isn't it better to get killed for believing in others?
What the f-
Doesn't that mean... Are you saying we should all just give up and die?
No. Nagito, there's definitely something wrong with you.
You guys only think there's something wrong with me because there's something wrong with you.
Oh, fuck no.
Suspecting each other.
I'm
like
glad
this.
I made it through this class trial.
There's no way
died.
Let's stop this already. We don't have to find out who the killer
is.
That's
very suspicious of you to say.
I can't stand this anymore. I don't want to do this to my friends.
I don't want to do this either.
Me too. I want to go home and eat candy!
Stop it. If everyone acts like this, I...
Everyone calm down.
We're all friends, aren't we?
Nagato,
there's
shut
no
your freaking bitch ass up, dude.
Murder enough.
Then why did Byakuya die?
Who cares? Let's just give up already.
Dude, you are so bullshit it's not even funny right now.
There are no clues that lead to the killer anyway.
Except for you, right now.
That's wrong.
Chikaki.
I think.
Dots.
Did you say something?
We've already found a clue that might point to who the killer is.
You know who the killer is?
The killer? I don't know. But we do have a clue about a suspicious person. I think.
I see. Then care to tell me, what's this clue you're talking about?
First of all, let's try thinking about how the killer was able to obtain the knife during the blackout.
Didn't we already cover that? They used glowing paint as a mark.
No, not that. I mean before that.
If they even had to obtain it by relying on the glove from the paint, they needed to get close to the table while it was still dark.
Let's try examining the situation. My hero's diagram might be useful.
The diagram of where everyone was standing before the blackout, right?
It's Nagato. Oh, I knew it from the start. Look at Nagato over there. First, we need to discuss how the killer was able to move that table in the dark. The killer probably used something to help them move in the dark. Fuck. Okay.
Crap. Crap.
Fuck. What am I supposed to do? Oh. There's a lamp. There's duct tape. What the fuck does the lamp have to do with anything?
Girl must have used the desk lamp to move to that table in the dark.
Oh, maybe.
Desk lamp? I hope you don't mean they turned on a light or something.
There was a blackout. There's no way the killer could have used the desk lamp.
It's the wire, though. The power cord.
I can prove it with this. They didn't turn the desk lamp on. They used its power cord.
Power cord?
They could have felt their way to that table using the power cord, right? By doing that, the killer was able to move to the table and use the glowing paint to find the knife.
And there's only one person here who could have done that.
Hey Nagato, what's up?
It was you, wasn't it?
Me?
Son, I figured you out from the very beginning. I started like 3 episodes ago.
Was you.
Gosh, this has just been me like watching, I feel like. But like, honestly, it's intense.
The only one who could have felt their way to the table using the power cord was Nagato!
I agree.
That's just a coincidence.
But still, you had a chance, right? Chance to hide the knife under the table?
It's true. Chance, well, when he was cleaning.
I see!
Nagato, weren't you cleaning the dining hall all morning? If so, you would have had a chance to hide the knife.
That's...
If you factor in the power cord and the time you spent cleaning, you're the only one who could have done it.
Seriously? That's all just a coincidence!
If it was just one coincidence, it'd be fine. But when it's one right after another...
Dude, Chikaki, you're smart.
I wonder, is something like that even possible?
Could it be? Did you give yourself cleaning duty on purpose so you could hide the knife under the table?
Oh, shit.
Now that you mention it, Nagato did prepare the drawing to pick who cleaned the dining hall.
Oh, shit. He was the one that prepared the note. That's why he knew Byakuya was going to do that. It's coming together.
Drawing,
it's coming
you?
Together.
That's not...
I don't know if you're the killer or not, but regardless, it proves that you're suspicious, right?
If that's the case, that strange speech you made earlier,
That was part of your plan, too.
Yeah.
You got us to lower our guard and tried to hide the fact that you did it, didn't you, you motherfucker?
Well, just admit it already!
Nagito, tell me you object to this. Frankly, I don't want to believe it either. We investigated together. You were so kind. I can't believe you're the one who killed Byakuya. Nagito, say something!
Yeah, why aren't you saying anything, dude? Voting time!
The Old Demons are working together to combat the despair of their friend's death! How wonderful! How beautiful it is!
Huh?
Those eyes. At that moment, Nagito's eyes. The darkness in his eyes shone brightly, if layers upon layers of darkness were folding into each other. As if hope and despair had crudely mixed together.
Let's cut to the chase. You're correct. It was my doing all along.
What the fuck?
I'm the one who hid the knife under the table before the party started.
Got it.
I'm the one who used the power cord to find my way to the table in the dark. And of course, I'm the one who caused the blackout. After all, there's no way I'd knowingly whip out a knife in front of everyone, right?
So he's just accepted that he's fucking dead.
Is it just me, or does he seem a little nuts right now?
But I never expected Byakuya to have night vision goggles. Because of that, we had ourselves a little scuffle under the table. And all saw how that played out.
Huh.
With a twist ending like this, I think we can all agree this ended up being a very interesting mystery. Byakuya performed admirably. Just stop it already! Seriously! What the hell happened to
Jesus.
You?
This episode's probably super long. I've been having so much, like,
is this
fun.
Your true
it's probably, like, 40
you
minutes. I'm sorry.
Lying to us this entire time?
Yeah.
Lie? That's outrageous. There's no way someone like me could have lied to you guys.
Intense dude.
Anyone else?
I knew it was him. You guys saw me like point him out, right?
Too arrogant to have dreams or cling to hope. Too disdainful to actually try. I've made peace with the fact that I'm a lowly, stupid, insignificant human who can't do anything right.
Holy crap! He's totally the type of guy who spent his childhood killing neighborhood pets!
He seems like the sort of person whose eyes light up while watching Friday the 13th. Just like me.
That's quite the hobby you have there. But, like, now's not really the time to bring it up.
Hey, Nagito! If you were behind all of this, then did you also send that threatening letter?
Yep. I sure did. There's nobody else on this island whose handwriting is that painful to look at, right?
But why would you send a threatening letter in the first place?
I think, somewhere deep in my heart, I was probably hoping to find someone who would stop my evil deeds. Well, I bet if that really was my reason, at least some of you would feel sorry for me.
Are you making fun of us?
By threatening Byakuya, Nagito was likely able to manipulate his actions.
I didn't even notice. I had no idea that he said that.
In doing so, Nagito was able to manipulate everyone to the scene where the murder would occur. Am I wrong?
That reminds me. Nagito was the one who suggested I guard the office.
The frame.
Oh, I get it. If Paco was guarding the storage room, Nagito wouldn't have been able to use the irons.
The threatening letter, along with all your suggestions.
Yeah.
Yep, that's true too. But you're wrong about one thing.
Huh?
I didn't need to rig the drawing for cleaning duty, you know?
If that's true, then how did you conveniently get picked for cleaning?
I see. Well, there's no way I'd expect you to remember it. A worthless talent for a worthless human. I see!
He's the ultimate lucky.
You're the ultimate lucky student. Then, did you?
That's right. Manus trusted my luck. I trusted I'd be picked for cleaning duty. You just relied on your luck? It's not just luck. It's true my talent sucks, but I'm still the ultimate lucky student, you know? At the time, Hajime said I wasn't lucky, but it was actually the opposite. I was lucky. That's why I got picked for cleaning duty. Just like I wanted.
I kinda knew it.
Enough. That... I don't care.
At first
about
I thought
anymore.
It was Pekko, because Pekko was gone. But the clues just kept pointing to that, to him.
Importantly, why did you kill Byakuya? Answer me!
Byakuya was a very capable leader. For someone like him to get killed? The despair. It's only fitting that you symbols of hope should use his death as a stepping stone to shine even brighter. That was my only motivation.
You're not making any sense!
I agree, dude.
Fine. Let's start the damn vote already. I'm ready to fucking kill this site.
I think we all are.
Please! Monokuma! Please, wait!
Huh? The fuck?
Fuck? Exactly.
How should I put this?
Shit just got intense.
Is...
What? What do you have?
What are you saying? He's already confessed, hasn't he?
Are they gonna throw a loophole? What the fuck?
I already know that, but... there's just...
Spit it out, girl. Dude... Swing it in another direction.
If you're little, then keep your mouth shut. Your ugly face is stressing me out. It makes me want to puke.
What the fuck? Is he actually not the killer? If he's not the killer, what the fuck am I supposed to do?
He
just confessed.
Might I suggest we listen to what she has to say?
Yeah, dude, listen to what she has to say.
No, we don't. The killer. Simply listening is... acceptable. However, I won't allow this to end with mere play. Now then, let us lift the curtain for our bloody spectacle.
From this point on, lines of white noise will appear to disrupt your reactions. Truth bullets will disappear if they touch these lines, so think of them as obstacles in your debate. Please time your truth bullets just right so they won't be interrupted by white noise. What the literal fuck? By the way, if the difficulty is sent to general, white noise won't appear at all. In that case, all it means is that the explanation didn't mean anything at all, and had no meaning whatsoever. Or this explanation. Oh, don't worry. I'm not going to fall into despair. Although it's meaningless, allow me to say one more thing. In this debate, you won't be able to shoot down the white noise. That'll be explained later. If you press the start button during the arguments, you can view the controls. Oh, fuck. I suck at this. I suck at this so hard. This is lasting so long. Ibuki's account, because he did the autopsy results. I'm going with the autopsy results. I'm going to listen to the whole thing, though. I've learned my lesson.
I
get strange that.
The killer is so obviously Nagito!
Killer is so obviously Nagito.
He has already confessed.
There's no reason to deny it.
You know...
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it.
He's okay.
He killed Byakuya with a knife he hit.
Oh, never mind.
No. That was it.
Thanks for wasting our time, skanky bitch.
Listen to what she has to say.
Let's prepare to cast our votes.
I know, she knows something that contradicts the crime scene.
I think it's strange.
It's very strange.
The killer is so obviously Nagito!
No.
He has already confessed.
no reason to deny it, no.
You know,
yeah.
That bastard Nagito is the one who did it.
No.
He killed Byakuya with a knife he hit.
No, that's wrong.
Yes, here we go. I'm getting good at this, kind of.
That knife might not be the murderer.
Quote unquote good.
That's what you wanted to say, right?
You have to listen to the whole conversation first.
What the hell are you
talking
about?
So you know what to refute.
It's obvious the knife was the murder weapon.
But based on the entry proof on Yaki's body, the actual weapon should be roughly 5 millimeters in diameter.
5 millimeters in diameter? That's like way skinnier than a knife.
Why would what's his name agree to it?
Hey, that better be true. If you screwed up, I'll sell your fucking ass to a whorehouse.
Not a whorehouse!
Hey, why are you threatening her?
Is this what you're trying to say, Mikan? As long as we can't prove that the knife is the murder weapon, we can't assume that I'm the killer.
But why did you confess?
What are you saying? No one else can be the killer.
That's a lie.
Hey, don't blame me. Mikan's the one who said it.
It's true.
Hey, Nagito. Are you still hiding something?
Hiding?
Like, during the blackout, did something happen between you and Byakuya that we don't know about?
They did struggle.
Who knows?
After all this, what else do you intend to hide?
Jeez, the moment your back's against the wall, you get all silent. You piss me off! What happened during the blackout? Ugh! If you cross your eyes like this, it gives you double vision!
Don't get distracted! Our lives are at stake, you know?
Huh? Whose life is at stake?
Seriously, how long is it gonna take for you to understand the damn rule?
Nobody can see in the dark. No matter how hard you think about it, the truth is
this video is gonna be so long. Part 2 of this is gonna be so long. Like, I don't wanna.
Despite the fact that it came from me. No, that's not it. Not it. What's not it?
I wanna finish the trial though. Maybe I'll split it into two. We gotta go to Ibuki's account.
I can prove it with this.
Ibuki's account says who's talking.
Even if we couldn't see what happened in the dark, I'm pretty sure someone could have heard it. Isn't that right, Ibuki?
For real?
You were the one who told me, remember? Where everyone was shouting during the blackout?
Everyone, calm down! We gotta stay calm in a situation like this!
Ah! Don't step on my feet!
Yoko-san.
What the hell? What's going on here?
Okay, so that's where he discovers the knife.
This is...
Ow!
Okay, that's the
Turn the damn lights on! I can't eat like this, you know!
You guys? Where are you? Wasn't the blackout just in the kitchen?
Perhaps the breaker overloaded?
Hold on a sec. I'll go along the wall and do something about it.
Such perceptive hearing. Impressive. I'd expect no
Why
less
are you
from the
fucking
ultimate musician.
I hate you so much, dude.
It's a good thing your ears are awesome because your face, style, figure, and personality totally suck.
You've cut me deep with your knife of truth.
However, after hearing what Byakuya and Nagito said in the dark...
What the hell? What's going on here? This is...
Ow!
It almost sounds like... Byakuya fought back against Nagito or something.
Well, that's actually what happened. As a sign of respect for Ibuki's talent, I have a small confession to make.
Got it. Let's go.
I was actually shoved out from under the table by Byakuya.
He shoved you out?
Just as the blackout occurred, I hurried to duck under the table and grab the knife. But Byakuya, wearing his night vision goggles, caught me and shoved me right out from under the table. That's right. I'm so incompetent that I couldn't even grab the knife.
Who's the first to jump on Nagito's case? I wasn't paying attention. who wasn't there. Sounds plausible. I mean, just from listening to what they both said at the same time.
What the hell? What's going on here?
Ow!
Okay. Well, actually, now that I think about it, it sounds like that's exactly
after what happened. Getting shoved out from under the table. Just as confused as you guys.
I want to be good at solving mysteries. I really do. I just don't know who it is.
I didn't even know where the power cord was. Before I realized it, the lights had come back on. Yaku's body was live.
Why the fuck would you admit to being the killer?
Hold on! Are you saying you're not the killer?
From the very beginning, the idea to throw a party, hiding the knife, setting up the blackout, it was all going according to plan, but unfortunately, my plan failed. And all thanks to Byakuya's night vision goggles.
We gotta watch you, dude.
What happened after that? Even I don't know. You failed? Then you're not the one who killed Byakuya?
What the?
Then we're right back to square one!
Exactly! Is it you?
How can that be? We spent all this time talking back and forth!
Wait. Tedder's account is the only one that can't be proven. And he had a skewer. One of the items was missing.
But you can't give up. You need to have hope.
Tedder.
Do your best and move forward. Rising to the challenge again and again is why you guys are the symbols of hope.
Is Nagato really? No, he's not. Okay, so it's changed now. I don't think he's the killer. I was all impressed with myself because I figured it out. It's Tedder. Tedder is the only one whose account can't be proven. He was in the kitchen. When he came in, he was like, hey, is the thing's not just, the blackout's not just in the kitchen. Did that happen after? Did that happen after? Or did that happen before? Because that's key. Fuck, that's key. It's possible. If we don't, we will die here. Suspended?
Well now.
Alright, we're gonna end it here because this episode has gone on way too long. I might split this up into two episodes, but I don't know actually how long it got. So, I'll check and I'll probably edit these if it is long. If it's like an hour, oh my goodness. If it's 40 minutes, I might leave it the way it is. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. This is Tubaplyr, NegativeAE. If you guys enjoyed it, leave a like and subscribe because I play a lot of Vagante and decision-based games, kind of like this one. Even though I feel like it's more like a linear thing, but I don't know. We'll see. I'll talk to you guys in the next episode. Peace out, guys.